All right, guys, how's it going today? Hope you enjoyed jazz music yesterday. Today, we're going to talk about a specific type of jazz music called blues music. If you've ever been to Memphis, down Beale Street, lots and lots of blues venues and stuff. So, blues, what is it? It is a music usually following a 12-bar pattern. We're going to see what that is in just a second. As a basis for its improvisation. Blues music can be happy or sad. Doesn't have to be super sad, okay? Remember, art doesn't always have to be super serious, right? It can be happy, or it could be fast, or it could be slow. There's no rules, okay? Except for a very specific pattern we're gonna learn in just a second. And blues music can be vocal, or it can be just instrumental. So, Bessie Smith, she is one of the most famous blues singers of all times. She was famous during the 1920s, and she's known as the Empress of the Blues. If you get a chance to watch, I'm pretty sure it's on HBO Go. I don't know if it's on Netflix or anything yet, but there's this movie called Bessie, and Queen Latifah plays Bessie Smith, and I learned so much about her life and all the struggles she went through. Especially during the 1920s and being a woman and being black, all the discrimination and stuff that she went through and how she overcame it all. She's an amazing person. So the blues follows a very specific pattern. I want you to listen to her song and see if you can figure out some of the patterns that you have to follow. Our 12 bar pattern, 12 syllables long, and then the next two lines are 5 to 6 syllables long, but the last word of the fourth line and the last word of the first line also have to rhyme. Okay, so why and goodbye, that's the pattern of the blues. So it's a very specific construction on how the song needs to be laid out. So, remember I said the blues can be happy or sad, fast or slow. So I wanted to show you this fun little thing. Conan O'Brien, he's super weird. I kind of get his weird sense of humor. Of how he got some first graders into writing some blues songs.
Chicago's a city that's famous for its blues. Unfortunately, a lot of young people aren't familiar with the blues as an art form. I wanted to introduce them to this great musical genre, so I sat down with a group of first graders at the Francis Xavier Ward Elementary School, right here in Chicago, and we learned a lot together. Check it out. This is what we're gonna do. We're gonna play the blues today, and you guys are gonna help me write some Chicago blues songs. Does that sound fun?
Yeah!
Now here's what we do. To write the blues, you write about something that's making you unhappy. And by singing about something that makes you unhappy, it makes you feel better. Or makes you feel much worse.
Yeah.
So what I want you to do is think about something that kind of bothers you about your everyday life. So what makes you kind of grumpy?
When I think about how my sister took my teddy bear when I was probably three.
Your sister took your teddy bear when you were three?
Well, me and my sister were playing around, but then she took it.
So she took your teddy bear. How long did she keep it for?
Well, actually, she sort of like jumped it off the bed, but I catched it.
Wait a minute. Your story's changing. You went from your sister stole your teddy bear, which is a great blues song, by the way, to your sister didn't really take your teddy bear, just pushed your teddy bear off the bed and you caught it. I gotta be honest with you, Summer, this isn't the most terrible story I've ever heard. And I've heard some bad things. What's that?
It is, but you live it.
Do you have any things in your life that make you irritated sometimes, like a brother that bothers you, or a kind of food you don't like?
Edamame.
Edamame? Wow, we didn't even have edamame when I was a kid. That's a food that kids don't like that was invented.
Mom and sister love edamame.
So this is the great tragedy of your life. My sister and my mother eat edamame, and I don't like it quite as much as they do. That's a blues song right there. In fact, it's been recorded in 1948. A little-known label that went defunct. Because all the songs were about edamame.
People at my table tease me because I don't get chocolate.
You don't get to have chocolate?
My mom doesn't pack me with chocolate on Wednesdays since I have cold lunch on Wednesdays.
Is there any day you're allowed to have chocolate?
On Friday, that's dessert day at school, so yeah.
One of the greatest things about the blues, one of the greatest themes is the man keeping you down. And this is the man keeping you down.
And your sisters are weird.
And your sisters are weird.
She said, absolutely, no chocolate in school. Every time I open up my lunchbox, I feel just like cool. No chocolate on a Monday. No chocolate on a Tuesday. It's the one sole exception to the rule.
Do you know what the blues are?
A little bit, yeah.
What do you know about the blues?
Wait, no.
What just happened there? What just happened to you?
No.
You just were in the middle of talking and then you bent over backwards and you almost split in half. Does that happen to you sometimes? You're talking to someone and all of a sudden your lower back just gives out?
No.
Because that's young. 7 is young to have lower back failure. What bothers you when you go to school?
On the playground, we go and we try and play, but we only end up talking about what we want to do, and then school's over and we leave.
So you never even get a chance to play because you spend a lot further. Oh, whoa! Are you okay? Your brother's annoying? What's your brother's name?
Joshua.
What does he do that annoys you?
He once threw a ball at my neck.
He threw a ball at your neck?
Yeah.
Did it hurt?
Yeah.
What did you do?
I just fell to the ground to wait till it was over.
That's my defensive strategy as well. That's what I always do when attacked. I fall to the ground and wait for it to be over. What else?
A lot of times, somebody does a slam dunk and a ball lands right on my head.
I'm noticing that a lot of your fears involve a ball striking your head or your neck. People just always throwing balls at you?
Sometimes over the fence.
I think if a kid right now in China threw a ball, it would somehow land on your head, wouldn't it?
I don't want to go to China, because...
You don't want to go to China?
I'm afraid that I'll say a word that means something mean in English, and then I'll get beat up.
Wow. That's a very original fear. Congratulations.
My name's Nathaniel, and I'm a saddest.
Do you have any brothers and sisters?
Yeah.
Are they nice to you?
Yeah.
Are they sometimes not so nice to you?
Yeah.
This police interview will be over shortly. We just need to ask you a few more questions.
Sometimes he throws stuff at me.
What does he throw at you?
Balls and footballs.
There's a boy I was talking to, and everyone's always throwing a ball at him.
I think he's in my class. Is it
Nathaniel. Everywhere he goes. If the space shuttle released a ball in space and it fell on Earth, it would hit Nathaniel on the head.
It would just kind of like hurt for a second,
right?
But then it would like get better. Like if you get hit by a softball.
Yeah.
I don't get softball. It's softball, but the ball is not soft at all. And if it hits you.
This is a Seinfeld routine. This is incredible. That was great. That was observational comedy. I'm gonna get you in a comedy club tomorrow. You should do 10 minutes on this. It's really fun. It's good. What's with these softballs? They say they're soft, but when they get hit with them, they really hurt. What's with that?
Remember, it doesn't have to be super serious. Some potential topics, your love life or lack thereof, okay? There's lots of material there. School, parents, money problems. You want to do something, but you can't. That's the story of your life, right? Food, TV shows, movies, civil rights, politics, sports, cars. Could be anything, okay? So, music, all right? Springtime, virus, okay? Could be anything, happy or sad. The first line has to be 12 syllables long, okay? What's a syllable? If you went to first grade that day, remember it's every time you open your mouth. So, if we're doing my name, Holly, how many syllables? Two. Bernard, Bernard, two, okay? So every time you open your mouth, that's a syllable. Next line needs to be exactly the same as the first, so you just rewrite it. Then the third line, it kind of starts the solution to your problem that you stated in your first two lines, and it's 5 to 6 syllables long, and then your fourth line is 5 to 6 syllables long, but the very last word in the fourth line has to rhyme with the first, okay? So I want you to write 4 verses for me, all right? So the first verse is on the first part of the page, and then the other 3 verses are on the back. You can send me a picture of your blues song. You can record your blues song and send it to me. That would be super fun. I can't wait to see what you come up with. So here's some music to inspire your writing.
Thank you.
right? Here's some examples from former students. This one cracked me up. Apparently, these little boys had gone through a very bad breakup. Walker Girls is the title. Walker Girls, they are so very fake. Walker Girls, they are so very fake. I'm so done with them. They are all sneaky snakes. Okay? Poor guys. We feel sorry for them. So, I'm not going to read the other verses because they are not G-rated. What is my rule all the time? G-rated, people. G-rated. I love this one. I'll read a couple verses of it. These two guys were in the weightlifting program at Walker High. So, the title of theirs is Weightlifting. Weightlifting is really hard and it hurts very bad. Weightlifting is really hard and it hurts very bad. We need more water breaks, but it gets the coach mad. Sometimes it makes Owen cry and almost pass out. Sometimes it makes Owen cry and almost pass out. Owen needs to man up and it makes Owen shout. Okay? So, doesn't have to be super serious. I love this one. This one is kind of serious. Super smart little boys wrote this one. It's about discrimination. Sometimes people choose the path to discriminate. Sometimes people choose the path to discriminate. We are all we have. Let's end all the hate. Some of us are born white. Some of us are born black. Some of us are born white. Some of us are born black. What does it matter? Let's have each other's back. What's the big picture? We are all different colors. What's the big picture? We are all different colors. Let's all come together. Let's act like brothers. Why do we choose to separate in our two parts? Why do we choose to separate in our two parts? Let's come together, share the love in our hearts. Isn't that sweet? And two little boys wrote that. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. Love deep kids. So, write your song. Send me what you write. I can't wait to see what you come up with. Okay, guys? So, love y'all. Have a good afternoon. You know, doesn't have to be super serious. Let's have some fun with it. You can do this. All right? I love all these. These are all super fun. All right, have a good afternoon, guys. Love you. Be safe.